Info Plus for genuine information.
Namaskar, Dashkarmin, Hamile, Tapaharlai, Sozan Media Dwara Prize, Tamra, Bivina Karikam Horma, Bivina Saichik Gontabi Hurka Barima, Tihako Saichik, Sosta Hurka Barima, Raw, Costa Halka Officer, Andrasta Bidia Tiably, Kulkun Gontabema Pound of Shaksan, Hane Bisema, Jan Kari Pradan Kari Rakasum, Azahami Hurta Pahala, Naya Gontabi, Saichik. हबको रूपमा विकसित हुन थालिरहेको स्टोनियाका बारेमा जानकारी गराउँदैछौं त्यसका लागि स्टडी स्टोनियाकी स्पोक पर्सन विशेष गरी त्यहाँको एजुकेशनको बारेमा साउथ एशियामा स्पेशली इन्डिया र नेपालमा प्रवर्धन गर्ने उद्देश्यका साथ पायल राजपूत नेपाल भिजिट गर्नु भएको छ आउनुहोस् न उहाँलाई कार्यक्रममा स्वागत गरौँ पायल यु आर वेलकम अन आवर शो
Thank you. Namaste.
Okay, especially talking about Estonia. It's a new destination for Nepali.
Right.
So, would you please give some information about your Nepal visit for this time?
All right. So, it's lovely to be here. It's a beautiful country to begin with. And I understand that Estonia is a fairly new destination for the Nepali students. But saying that, we got a number this year that there were 90 students who are there in Estonia as of last year to study, which is a good news. So to give you a bit of initial background about Estonia, it's a European country. It is 20 minutes from Helsinki, Finland via flight, 2 hours from sea. And Estonia is the global superpower of cybersecurity. So 19 years ago, when they regained independence from the Soviet Union, they had two options. One is to grow in an infrastructure state like Dubai did, or they had to progress in a digital, on the digital wave to become first in a lot of things, and they did. The first e-voting that took place in the world took place in Estonia. Cybersecurity comes from Estonia, and therefore a very strong e-governance system. Very often will you see a lot of young talent, as young as 21, who is the CEO of a digital company. And mm-hmm. then that brings us back to this question, that what is it that makes the country number one in so many things? Mm-hmm. And the answer to that is education.
Okay, especially talking about education, you are promoting Study Estonia. So I think there is a couple of universities and educational institution. Would you please give some information about that?
Right, so in Estonia we have 8 universities, 6 public universities, 2 private. And the QS ranking of all these universities falls under 500. The oldest university is the University of Tartu, which was formed in 1600. Mm-hmm. And that also is the most strongest university when it comes to research. And so is the University of Tallinn, which is also called as Taltech University.
Especially talking about the courses, mm-hmm. Would you please highlight something?
Right, so as I mentioned, Estonia as a country not only emphasizes just on education, but they have a very strong culture of industry integration from classroom learning. Mm-hmm. So when we look at the courses are very innovative and progressive mm-hmm. and very applicable in today's society. So you can expect a bachelor's in entrepreneurship and startup, you can expect a bachelor's in innovation and creativity. There are integrated engineering courses, which is a 5-year course, and you get a knowledge of economics, IT, communications, digitization, etc. And then when we talk about masters, it gets even more interesting, because the master's courses are, there is an MBA in digitization, there is a master's program in innovation and technology. There is mechatronics, which is a combination of mechanical and electronic engineering. There's masters in robotics and computer science. There's a very special course in education, which is masters in education and innovation as well. So we are seeing a lot of sectors other than IT and ITC, which is humanities, law, medicine, and extra innovation, digitization courses as well.
Okay, is there any option for the film and theatre?
Yes, there is University of Tallinn, and then there is University of Arts, which is again a Tallinn University of Arts. That has a very interesting course in film and technology. and there's courses in music and arts. In fact, there's one student from Nepal that is studying in the University of Tartu and is pursuing his master's in folklorics, which is the study of traditional music.
Okay, so what are the basic requirements to enroll on this university, especially talking about the graduate and undergraduate?
As a rule of the Estonian Education Ministry, 50% marks in all subjects is a criteria. IELTS of 5.5 and above is required. And there is a very strong emphasis on motivational letter, which is your proof of work. That simply defines why is it that you would want to this particular course, because Estonia believes a lot in career progression. They want quality students to come to Estonia, not just for study, but they want to retain them as skilled and talented workforce as well. So in order to meet the end-to-end career progression for a child, it's very important that they keep these things factored in. Based on all these three elements, there is an evaluation which is conducted by the university, and that also decides the amount of scholarship the student will get. Like other countries, there is no disparity on the levels of hierarchy of who gets the job first or who gets the scholarship first. It's not that if it is a student from non-EU, they have a third or a fourth ranking, like few other countries in the world. They all fall in the same bracket for jobs as well as for study. So these are the criteria which also help them decide, or the university decide on what is the evaluation criteria for scholarship, which can be anywhere up to a 100% tuition fee waiver.
Okay, so especially talking about the international student community inside the Estonia,
right,
as you are representing the Study Estonia program, so how they are entertaining and how they are growing their career inside the Estonia?
So with international students, like I mentioned earlier, that Estonia is they call themselves e-Estonia. The reason why we say e-Estonia is because we take pride in calling ourselves a digital nation, which means that there are four unicorns that have come out of it. The birthplace of Skype is Estonia. And we have TransferWise, which is a payment transfer gateway. There is Taxify, which is an app that is giving Uber a run for its money. There's Fivedrive. These unicorns have hit 1 billion already, which means that there are hundreds of companies that the students have options to work in, not just IT, but then there's manufacturing, F&B, the travel tourism industry as well. So the options for students to work is a lot. There isn't a restriction on the amount of part-time working hours for students like in other countries. So they can work over 20 hours as well while they are studying. And obviously, if they stay in the indicators of what is required by their professors, they can work over 20 hours.
Okay. Especially WRI Education Consultancy is promoting Estonia education here in local market. So is there that sort of the combined future plan so that students can get easily information about the Estonia?
Yeah, so we've had a very overwhelming response about students from Nepal wanting to come study in Estonia. And since we do not have our office based here, because this is not a target country at the moment, we thought that looking at WRI as our body, that we can co-collaborate with it together to filter the right kind of qualitative students for their career progression would be great. So WRI is a very professional consulting firms. I've met some students today. In fact, we have a profiling session tomorrow, but we had some students come in today, and I'm happy to say that they were all very good students.
Okay, those students and parents who are looking after the abroad study option in Europe, what is your message to them to choose Estonia especially?
So my message to the parents, because they think that it's a great concern for their kid when they go to study abroad, but my message is that even if your child wants to go for an undergrad or wants to go for a master's, It is one of the safest countries in the world. It has the cleanest air and the purest water. It's only, the time difference is only 3.5 hours. There is, from a perspective of larger countries which are hours away, from Delhi to Helsinki and ahead, it's a total 9.5 hour travel time that you get there in. The fee structure is extremely competitive. So we are looking at fee structure of anywhere between 2,000 euros to 6,000 euros per year tuition fee, which in comparison to the large global countries and universities is 1/4. Mm-hmm. So it's very affordable for the parents as well when they want to consider that their child can study abroad. It's as is at par as what they would pay in their own country for their child to study. And then the chance of getting 100% tuition fee waiver, depending on how good the candidate is, also helps. The opportunity to work while you're studying, which helps you get a practical knowledge on what the subject is, gets you oriented for the industry in advance. And the student also builds themselves on a lot of grounds. There is study, there is work. It's a very internationalized country. There are people from all parts of the world. And not only being an IT hub, but also being a huge tourist destination, they get to see many other cultures and how to conduct themselves in other cultures. So there's not only a growth that a person has in terms of education, but I think a 360 degree holistic as well.
Okay, finally, anything else?
No, this is a great country. It's my first time here, and I look forward to be back sometime soon. And message to the students is we hope to see you in Estonia soon.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.